I got him back.
Yeah. You sat on his lap.
I sat on his lap when the shooter was was opening for him recently. On his bus, I ended up getting drunk with him. Well, he didn't get drunk. He took some shots with me. And I accidentally sit on his lap. And
he's trying to take a picture with him.
Yeah. Sat picture on his lap, yeah. Merle said, "You know you're on my lap?" And I said, "Well, no, I don't. And I'm sorry, I'll get off."
He also didn't know you were.
Yeah, right. But anyway, yeah, that was a great experience.
Girl, he taught me how to hurt real bad and cry myself to sleep. He showed me how this town can shatter a dream. Another lesson about a naive fool that came to Babylon. Found out that the paddle tastes so sweet. Now it's guitars, Cadillacs, and hillbilly music. Lonely, lonely streets that I call home. Guitars, Cadillacs, and hillbilly music is the only thing that keeps me hanging on. There ain't
Hi, this is Dwight Yoakam, and I'm sorry that I'm not able to be there in person with everybody. But John Hensley was a dear guy, and the purest form of manager you could ever ask to have, that was someone who was a fan of music and a fan of the artist that he represented, and a tenacious defender of every artist that he worked with. And an advocate, as only a pure and absolute patron of the arts can be. I mean, that term patron of an art, of the arts, or an artist is thrown around, but John Hensley was the best advocate any artist could ever hope to have. And, was always a gracious gentleman to me and my family, friends. Anytime I was around him, first time I met him, he had Loretta Lynn out with Jack White, and I went down to the El Rey Theater, and we became friends that night and stayed friends right up to his passing. I would get random text messages from John. I'd be on one end of the country or somewhere in the world and get something saying that he had been watching, you know, whatever on YouTube, or he came across something he wanted to know if I'd seen. And it was always something that left my heart with a smile. You know, to his family and friends, you have my condolences, but my heartache for the loss of John. Good guy. Really good man.
When I was a boy, my family would travel. Down to western Kentucky, where my parents were born. To a lost little town there that's often remembered. So many times that my memories are worn. And Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County? Down by the Green River where paradise lay. He said, I'm sorry, my son, but you're too late to ask me. Mr. Peabody's cold rains hauled it away. Well, sometimes we travel right down the Green River. To the abandoned old prison down by Adria Hill. Where the air smelled like snakes, we chewed our pistols. All but empty pop bottles is all we would kill. And Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County? Down by the Green River where paradise lay. Said, I'm sorry, my son, but you're too late asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train has hauled it away. They tortured the timber and stripped all the land. Lord, they dug for their coal till the ground was forsaken. Then wrote it all down as the progress of man. Won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County? Down by the Green River, where paradise lies. He said, I'm sorry, my son, but you're too late in asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train's hauled it away. When I die, let my ashes float down the Green River. I let my soul roll on up to the Rochester Dam. I'll be halfway to heaven with paradise waiting. Just 5 miles away from where I am. Oh, and Daddy, won't you take me back to Muhlenberg County? Down by the Green River where paradise lay. He said, I'm sorry, my son, asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train is hauled away. He said, I'm sorry, my son, but you're too late asking. Mr. Peabody's coal train is hauled away. Oh, Mr. Peabody's coal train is hauling it away.